कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय हरये परमात्मने प्रणतक्लेशनाशाय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। भक्त भक्ति भगवंत गुरु चतुर बपु नाम एक इनके पद वंदन किए ना सही विघ्न नैक। प्रहलाद नारद पराशर पुंडरीक व्यासंबरी सशुक भीष्म दलभ्यम रुक्मांगदार्जुन वशिष्ठ विभीषणादिन पुण्यानीमान परम भागवतम स्मरामि। ध्यानमूलं गुरुर्मूर्ति पूजामूलं गुरुपदं मंत्रमूलं गुरुर्वाक्यं मुख्यमूलं गुरुकृपा। आई बाउ टू माय बिलव्ड मास्टर, आई बाउ टू लॉर्ड जगन्नाथ महाप्रभु। फीलिंग द प्रेजेंस ऑफ डिविनिटी within you, I bow to you all also. It is said in the scripture, durlabha manusa deha dehinam khyana bhangura. Human body is rare, but it has no guarantee. We do not know how many days we will live in this physical body. Tomorrow what will happen to us, even we don't know. While walking, while sleeping, someone left his body. So breath has no faith. Any time it can leave us. Nishwase naiva vishwasa kadarudhya bhavishyati. At any moment, this breath, this faithful breath will leave us. So as long as the breath is there in our physical body, and it is, we get it by the grace of God, so we should be very loyal to this breath. We should be very carefully conscious to this breath. Last class, we have discussed about a great devotee of Lord Krishna. His name is Billa Mangala. Billa Mangala came to his house for the death ceremony of his father. At evening time, he wanted to go that side. He wanted to go the other side of the river where the prostitute lives. So when he get ready to leave the house, at that time the wife of Billa Mangala requested him, "Oh my dear husband, you should not leave this place today. If you want to go there, you can go tomorrow." She tried her best to stop Billa Mangala not to go to the prostitute house, because that day was a very, very special day. That day was the death anniversary of his father. But Billa Mangala did not listen. Billa Mangala did not care to the words of his faithful, devoted wife. His wife tried her best to stop him, but she could not. Finally, Billa Mangala left that house, came to river bank to go to the other side to meet the Chintamani, the prostitute. Looking at this behavior of Billa Mangala, his wife get shocked. She was in trouble, what to do? My father-in-law has left his body. Thinking about Billamangala. Now Billamangala left me. So how could I live? If my husband left me, how could I live? How could I show my face to other? It is a very sadful situation for the wife. She does not like to live more. He was thinking, Lord, oh my Lord, give me a solution. What to do? I don't like to live in this body. With pain, with tension, with hypertension, I do not want to live in this body. I want to leave this body. So after leaving the house, the wife decided to end her life, to take suicide. Billamangala left the house after few minutes or after few hours. The wife of Billamangala also left her own house, went to river bank. Standing near the river, looking at the flow of the water, she decided to jump into the river, and finally she jumped to the water, and it is the end of her life. Very painful situation. Thinking of Billamangala, she left her body. And in the other side, Billamangala was searching here and there in the river bank. How to cross the river? The flow of the current, the flow of the water was very high. It is a terrible situation. How to cross a flooded river because it was a rainy season? He was thinking there. How could I go there? How could I cross the river? Because it is really impossible to cross the river because the current of the water was very severe. Separation from the prostitute makes Billamangala unhappy. Billamangala was searching and here and there to get some instrument. By the help of that instrument, he wanted to cross the river, but he did not get any instrument. No boat was there. Out of separation, so Billamangala decided, I can't live without Chintamani the prostitute. If I don't go there, without the company of Chintamani, I will die. So better to try. So he finally decided to cross the river by swimming. He jumped into the water and tried to swim. Swimming. After a few minutes, he found that it is really very difficult to swim against the current, against the flow of the water. In the middle of the river, he felt it is really very difficult to swim. He lost his energy. What to do? I have to die now. At that critical time, he thinks of God. Oh God, please help me. Please guide me, please help me. I want to cross the river. I want to meet my beloved. And God is also so kind. As if it is the play of God, he found something like a small wood. So taking the help of that wood, he crossed the river. reaching the other side of the river, he went to the house of that prostitute, Chintamani. And he found there all the doors were closed inside. He knocked at the door. Nobody is listening. He tried to bring the attention of that Chintamani, but no one is responding from inside. Finally, he decided, I will climb the wall and jumped into the house of prostitute. When he climbed, he found something like a rope was hanging there. So with the help of that rope, he climbed the wall and jumped into the corridor of that prostitute. Actually, that was not a rope, that was a snake. So with the help of that snake, he climbed up and entered into the house of that prostitute. Looking at the face of Billa Mangala, looking at the condition of Billa Mangala, that prostitute got shocked. She was surprised. How do you come here? It is a rainy day, rainy night. You can't stay there at least for one day. You should not come here. Because today is a very special day for you, the death anniversary of your father. Why do you come here? Can you not live for a single day without me? Billa Mangala said, oh my beloved, how can I live? How can I live without you? You are my everything, as if you are my soul, as if you are my body, as if you are my everything. So I can't live a single moment without you. The prostitute gets shocked listening this and said, how do you come? Now, at that time, Billa Mangala said, oh my beloved, you have kept a piece of log for me to cross the river. The prostitute said, no, I did not keep anything. Let us come and see. And when they came there, they found it is not a piece of wood. It is a dead body. And that dead body is the dead body of the wife of that Billa Mangala. Looking at the face of that faithful wife, that devoted wife, Chintamani gets shocked and returned back to his home and found he climbed the wall taking the help of a snake. It was not a rope, it was a snake. So the wife is Chintamani now gets shocked and uses some harsh word, scolded him like anything. You stupid Billa Mangala, you nonsense Billa Mangala, why do you have so much of love for this physical body? This body is made of 5 elements. Khitijala pavaka gagana samira pancha rachita ye adhama sarira. This body is made of blood, fleshes, bone. So why do you have so much love for this physical body? I don't like all these things. Listening this word, this painful word, it was change of his life. It is a great time by the play of divine, by the play of God, he gets changed. Detachment come to his mind. He decided, from today, I will surrender myself before the feet of God. From today, I will spend my whole life with thinking of God, chanting the name of God. And that prostitute also decided, I don't like this type of work, this type of prostitute work I don't like at all. And both of them decided to do kirtana in the whole night. They did kirtan there. And those people, those who are staying nearby that house, they came to know, they found kirtan is coming there. The sound of the kirtan is coming there. What a surprise, what a change. Every day singing, dancing, merrymaking were there. Now it is a change, it is a complete change. The name of God, the sound of the God is coming from that house. Nearby people, they astonished. And tomorrow morning, the next morning, Billa Mangala left that house, left everything for the sake of God. On the way, he took the help of a great master. His name is Somagiri. Somagiri is his master, spiritual master. He stayed with him nearly 1 year. Then he decided, I have to go Vrindavan. I have to meet my Lord Krishna. I have to see my Lord Krishna. So he decided to go Vrindavan. And he started his journey, spiritual journey, to go Vrindavan. On the way, he found a village. He was sitting nearby a tree and found a beautiful young married lady taking shower, returning to her house. Looking at the beauty of that woman, Billa Mangala again get attracted. So he followed that lady, that married lady. That married lady was a great devotee of Lord Krishna also. And her husband is also a great devotee of Lord Krishna. The young married lady entered to his house and Billa Mangala sat near the door of that house. After few minutes, the husband of that wife came and found a sadhu, a saint is sitting there. So he requested, O saint, O sadhu, please come. Please come to my house. They treated him like anything and then came to know, why do you sit here? What do you need? At that time, Billa Mangala with the open heart told, I want to see your wife. Your wife is very beautiful. I just want to see. As they are a very, very devoted one, the couple. So the husband said to his wife, please fulfill the demand of that sadhu. Then the wife of that sadhu, the wife of that person came there. Billa Mangala, looking at the face, beautiful face of that person, that lady, he got shocked. Now he changed his mind. What did I do? I left everything for the sake of God. Now again I get attracted towards the beauty of another lady. It is not good at all. It is in scripture. It is said, Khuda Turanam Nahi Patra Suddhi. Trusna Turanam Nahi Suddha Suddhi. Nidra Turanam Nahi, Nidra Turanam, Nahi Bhumi Sajya, Kama Turanam, Nahi Loko Lajya. Khuda Turanam. One who is really hungry, he will not look at the cleanness of that pot. First he will eat. One person who is really thirsty, he did not look at the cleanness of the pot. And one who is really, really sleepy, he can sleep everywhere. Anywhere he can sleep. Even sitting on the chair, even sitting on the roadside, he can sleep because he is really, really hungry. Even sometimes in meditation, those who are a little bit sleepy, in relaxation technique, we can listen to the divine sound, the snoring sound, because they are sleepy. And kamaturanam nahi lokalajya. So, lokalajya, he is not looking at the same. Because he was attacked by desire, passion, lust. But by the grace, he realized it. Billa Mangala realized it. So Billa Mangala requested that lady, "Oh Devi, please, can you give me one thing?" That lady asked, "What do you need, Baba? What do you need? Now, can you give me two needles?" "Yes, Baba, I am coming." That lady went to the another room and bring two needles. At taking these two needles in two hands, Billa Mangala pierced his own eyes. Blood is coming out from the eyes. Looking at this behavior of that lady, she gets up and called his husband, "Please come here. Blood is coming from the eyes of that sadhu." Oh sadhu, what did you do? You have lost your eyes." At that time, Billa Mangala said, "I am so unfortunate, and you are so fortunate. You are really so devoted to gods. I am a sadhu, I am a saint, but my behavior is not good at all. So for this eyes, it is a hindrance, it is a problem for me to walk on the path of spiritualism. So I wanted to spoil my two eyes." Oh my God. At that time, that husband of the house requested, "Baba, you have lost your eyes, so it is difficult for you to go anywhere. So you can stay here. I can arrange everything for you. You just stay here." Billa Mangala said, "No. I left everything. Now I left my eyes, so I have to go for the sake of God only. Only God. I don't like anything." So he started his journey for Vrindavan. He has lost his eyes. It is very difficult to walk on the road. After walking few miles, he found it is really difficult to walk in the jungle. He was praying, "God, oh, I lost my eyes. What to do? How to walk? He's hungry now." He was praying. At that time, looking at the condition of the devotee, Lord Krishna came there as a cowherd boy. Lord Krishna told, "Baba, what do you need? Where do you want to go?" "My boy, I want to go to Vrindavan." "Why do you want to go to Vrindavan?" "Baba, I want to have the darshan of Lord Krishna." "Baba, you have lost your eyes. How can you see?" At that time, Billa Mangala said, "Look, I have no eye. I have no eyes. I lost my eyes. But my Lord Krishna, he has eyes. So if I am unable to see him, but he can see me, I just want my God will see me. That is enough for me." that cowherd boy, Lord Krishna, told Baba, God is everywhere. Hari sarvatra samana, prema se pragata hoi jagajana. Billamangal said, oh boy, I know Hari sarvatra samana, God is everywhere, God is all pervading. But I have not that much of love, I have not that much of a devotion to see God everywhere. So I want to go Vrindavan. Baba, how will you go? I will go. If you can help me, I will go with your help. Yes, Baba, I will help you. Now, do you know where is Vrindavan? Yes, Baba, I know it. So, he took the hand of Billamangala, that cowherd boy, taking the hand of Billamangala, started the journey. When he catch the hand of Billamangala, Billamangala felt something very special. He felt some spiritual power coming to his body. So he realized, he understand, this boy is no one, maybe the boy is Lord Krishna. So Billamangala catch strongly the hand of Lord Krishna, the cowherd boy, and wanted to say, oh Lord Krishna, I know you are Lord Krishna, you are not cowherd boy, you are Lord Krishna. At that time, Lord Krishna threw the hand of Billamangala, and Billamangala was crying. You left me, I left everything for you, and now you left me. At that time, Billamangala chant,
Hastam utkhipya jatasi balat krishna kimadhutam hrudayat jadinirjasi paurasam ganayamite.
Hey Krishna, I know you are the most powerful person of the universe. I know you have more energy. I am energyless. I am a old man. But if you have strength, if you have power, can you go away from my heart? It is really impossible for the God. God can't leave the heart of the devotee. So, just looking and listening the sound of his devotee, Lord Krishna shows his beautiful form of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna give a divine eyes to that Billamangala. Billamangala looking at the beautiful body, beautiful form of the Lord Krishna, bow down and requested, oh Lord Krishna, I want to go Vrindavan. Let us go Vrindavan. Baba, I gave this eyes for you. Now you can see everything. Billamangala said, no, I don't like this eyes. Because these eyes are problem for me. Many times these eyes are creating problem for me. So I don't want to get this eyes. I want just you. I want to see you in my heart. So again Lord Krishna returned back his divine eyes and he went to Vrindavan. He sat there, always chanting the name of Lord Krishna and spending his life there. Every day, Lord Krishna came with a paper ball with some sweet, with some food. Every day, Billamangala eat there and spend his life in meditation. After a few days, that Chintamani, that prostitute came to know that Billamangala was staying at Vrindavan and he was a realized man. He had the darshan of Lord Krishna. So she came there and both meet each other. But no passion is there, no lust is there, only devotion is there. So Billamangala gave a bowl of sweet given by Lord Krishna to Chintamani, to the prostitute. But that prostitute said, no, I don't like this. It was given by Lord Krishna to you only, so I will not eat it. If Lord Krishna will come here and give me a paper pot, some food, some prasad, then I will eat. Looking at the strong determination of the Chintamani, Billamangala also did not eat anything. He left the paper ball and praying Lord Krishna, please come here, give another paper, give little more prasad for Chintamani. After few hour, Lord Krishna came there with a paper ball, with some prasad. Due to Billamangala, Chintamani also get the darshan of Lord Krishna. Both became realized now, and both of them, they spend their life with chanting, meditation, spend their life. It is a great story. It is not a story actually, it is really happened. So they spend their life there. Now time is over, so let us chant the prayer.
Also, sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santo niramaya, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschid dukkha bhag bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.